Let us start. In the last class, before the Puja vacation, we have started this refrigeration air conditioning lab here. As I can't show you the actual lab, actual equipment itself, I have to take the use of different building materials as well as different pictures and videos to clarify the matter as much as possible. Now, what we'll do? We have in our lab laboratories only vapor compression refrigeration system itself. I told you what are the different constituents or what are the different parts in a vapor compression refrigeration system. One is defined as compressor. Another is like this here. This is the compressor itself. If you could consult upstairs, this is the compressor. It contains an expander here. Or it's called expansion valve of the refrigerant or refrigerant control valve. We have one evaporator itself. We have one condenser itself. So there are two, three, four parts: compressor, expansion, throttling valve, evaporator, condenser. And we have other gadgets like pressure gates, start-stop switch, temperature thermometer, this type of refrigerator, etc. Now, before going to the further details, I'm showing you the pictures of the present lab equipment itself. What is shown here is first the air conditioning setup. This is the air conditioning machine, air conditioner, the front side of a air conditioner, although it's not like our room air conditioner itself. Beside this screen, we have the compressors, expansion valve, etc. What we show here, this is a chute-like substance in which from which the cold air will come up and cool the room itself. It also has a heater, heating coil, which can be run separately to increase the temperature of the outside heater in order to know the heat factor of the refrigerator itself. What is shown here is, you see, it's a measuring device of the electricity which we are using here. In other words, it is called a cyclometer, mechanical energy cyclometer. And what is shown here is the thermometer itself, which has six different readings, T1, T2, T3, T4, T5, T6. And what is shown here, the red side is the highest pressure or high pressure line, the pressure at the exit of the compressor, and green side is the lower pressure line, pressure at the exit of the expansion valve itself. So, and this is the green side, and this is the red side, and this is the control of the pressure in the exit and at the exit of the expander or throttle valve, and this is the red side at the exit of the compressor itself. Compressor is hidden here, and this is the throttle valve, which is shown here in a small cell itself. Let me share the other plots, photos like this. Now, this is a standard vapor compression refrigeration test rig. It is more or less visible, because it don't have much items inside it, outside your range, outside your thinking, I mean, outside your look. Here, what is shown here? This is the compressor itself, which is defined as hermetically sealed condenser. I will give the definition and explain the definition, and in latter parts of the day, at the same time, I will show you a few videos for it. Just 1 second. So this is the compressor, and this is a extension. This is actually the condenser itself, which is being cooled by a fan here, which is being run by the compressor shaft to give the cold air to cool the compressor itself, through the condenser itself. And the pipe shown here through which the refrigerant will move, will convert from vapor compression vapor to liquid state itself. Next, from the condenser itself, it will go to the throttle valve or expansion valve here, which there by means of yellow line is the supply line to this throttle valve itself. And this throttle valve will expand the valve, and it will move out from it and go inside the condenser itself. What is condenser is this box. This is a water tank whose inside wall is totally surrounded by the coils of the evaporator itself. This is the evaporator which is being supplied from the external valve, and this expansion valve will send the liquid refrigerant to this evaporator, where it is evaporated to the gaseous, and thus absorbing the latent heat of evaporation from the content of this tank, which is generally a water. So it will cool the water up to more or less near to the 0 degree centigrade also, or else around 4-5 degree centigrade. And this air is being consumed from the water by means of evaporation of the condenser refrigerant itself. And from evaporator itself, from the outlet of the evaporator, it goes to the inlet of the compressor, where in gaseous form, it is being sucked by the compressor and compressed to a high pressure, and then sent to the condenser itself. What is else is shown here? That lower pressure gauge and higher pressure gauge, which higher pressure gauge is marked as red and lower pressure gauge is marked as green. This is on-off switch of the whole system, and this is the electromagnetic energy meter. It is electromagnetic energy meter, which is just consuming, which is just calibrating the amount of energy which is being used due to the whole process of refrigeration itself. And this is the thermometer, which is not digital, but it has different position where it will be, if you kept T1, T2, T3, T4, and on the side here, on this round side here, and did that respective temperature in digital form here. So what is given? Again, I am just narrating quickly. Compressor, next condenser, next throttle valve or expander, next evaporator itself. And supportings are there, low pressure gauge, high pressure refrigerant gauge, measuring electromechanical energy meter, main switch, on-off switch, and thermometer itself. Also, this compressor has different outlets through which we can inject the refrigerant if it is generally reduced in MO. But same refrigerant is being circulated from compressor to evaporator to throttle valve, throttle valve to the condenser, and then back to compressor itself. Unless there is some provisional leakage or some certain amount of evaporation takes place in some way, this valve, it will not reduce this temperature itself. Next, let us go for another test strip. what we are seeing here, here what we see here is the another test strip, which is also working on a vapor compression ignition compression process, vapor compression refrigeration process. But the here what we use as a condenser and what is used as a evaporator is quite different. Here you see we are using a hermetically sealed compressor here again, where the its inlet of this compressor is given is by this yellow input line, where you can fit by means of a particular feeding device the additional refrigerant if you require. And from the compressor, it is the outlet is compressor high pressure vapor gaseous refrigeration system will comes at the condenser itself. Here what you see, condensers are made of tubes just in a kept or assembled in a spiral form here, like here, this, and these tubes almost they are in 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. They are actually supported by the fins, which is also holding the tubes in proper rigid position and also transmitting the heat from the refrigerant from to the surroundings by means of convection itself. From the refrigerator itself, from the compressor it comes to the condenser, and from the condenser it comes to the throttle valve, which is shown here. This is the throttle valve or expander valve, which is given, which is receiving on the condenser the high pressure but liquid refrigerant, whose pressure it is released and thus converted to low pressure liquid refrigerant and then sent to the evaporator here, which is shown here. But through the evaporator pipe, it is absorbed. It goes through the as a liquid refrigerant, and where it is absorbs the its latent heat of evaporation from the space given in this particular transfer evaporator here, which it's like a can of water is kept to adjust this temperature itself. Then this liquid condenser, liquid refrigerant goes through all the pipes throughout this evaporator, then comes out and thus comes to the inlet of the compressor itself, like this, which is shown here. This is the energy meter. This is the thermometer, which is shown here, and this is the main switch, which is being used to start and stop the machine. So here we are using the same throttle valve and same pneumatic is a atmospheric compressor, and but different type of condenser and different type of evaporator itself. Hermetically sealed condenser, I made the long system. Let us go for another one. Now, this is the fourth one of the vapor compression test tricks which we have in our laboratories. It is what is shown here, the hermetically sealed compressor. This is the condenser here. This is the condenser pipe starting from here. It's going up. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 pipes are there. And pipes are being supported as well as by the fins, like this straight lines, vertical lines, which carrying the pipe as well as distracting or converting the heat from the pipe itself. Pipe is carrying the compressed vapor at high pressure, which is being converted to compressed liquid refrigerant at high pressure itself. From the outlet of this refrigerant, it goes to throttle valve itself, where it is expanded to low pressure liquid refrigerant, and from the refrigerant itself, it goes to the evaporator itself. This is the a standard refrigerator which you use in daily life of around and let it hit the liter capacity, and through the coils of the evaporator inside the refrigerator, it runs, and from there it absorbs the heat, the heat of evaporation of the refrigerant from the surroundings, and thus it is creating a cooling atmosphere inside the refrigerator itself, and then supplied this low temperature vaporized refrigerant to compressor for the next cycle of operation itself. Thus we have four different type of refrigerant on pressure itself. Next, let us go through the video of the system itself. Let's go to the stuff share. Let us go through the video first, then I will discuss again to where the mode matter itself. This is our vapor compression refrigeration test rig. What we are showing here, first, this is the our condenser, which is where we are using a cooling fan to cool the refrigerant passing through this passing through the tubes of the condenser. This is, we are showing our hermetically sealed compressor, and this is our expansion device or capillary device. This is a digital meter used for registering the power input, and the high pressure of the system is being registered here, running by the red line, and low pressure of the system is being shown in this pressure gauge given by the green line. This is the temperature, this is the thermometer where we can show T1 to T6 temperature, which is fixed at different points of the thermometer itself. Last, this is our refrigerator. This is our evaporator, which is looks like a tank, and which contains
which contains the cooling coils as shown here, and it cools the water, the pool of water contained here. Hello, this is another vapor compression refrigeration test rig. Here we are having the compressor, hermetical sealed compressor in front of us. Next, we are having the condenser, which is air cooled here and not cooled by any fan itself. Over it, we have our two pressure gauges, which indicates the high pressure and low pressure of the system. High pressure is the red gauge and green is the low pressure itself. And in front of us is the evaporator of the system, which is inside a glass bowl casing, and inside we are seeing the these tubes carrying the refrigerants surrounding this refrigerator system. Next, we are having the digital wattmeter, which is measuring the power input during the process running of this refrigerator test rig. And below it, the main switch of the system, and above that, the thermometer, which records 6 different thermometer as per its setting, T1 to T6, which is gives us the thermometer of temperature of different portion itself. And below everything, which is showing our expansion device or throttling device, which works as the expander of the system itself. Let us describe another refrigeration test rig. Here we are showing first the hermetically sealed compressor itself, which is works as a compressor, and behind it we are having our condenser system, which is air operated, and it is totally reduces the temperature of the refrigerant by exchange of heat through the surrounding atmospheric air. Over that, we are having our two pressure gauges, which indicates the high pressure and low pressure of the system. High pressure is the system indicated by red one, and low pressure is indicated by the green one itself. At the right of it, we are having our expansion device or throttling device, which uses or due to the expansion of the fluid after the condensation is complete. Beyond that, we are having our digital wattmeter, which is a recorder of power which is being used during the running of this refrigeration test rigs. Next, we are having a thermometer, which is recording and showing us the 6 different thermometer, T1 to T6, at 6 different points of the upper circular operation. By its sides, we are having our main switch, which is starts and stops the system. Now, in front of all of us, we are having our refrigerator or evaporator system, which looks like a normal domestic refrigerator itself. Inside of it is familiar to us in our household refrigeration system, and this is the deep fridge, and inside which we are having our the tubes for evaporators, and inside below that there is a rack, and into the front door there is a rack itself. This is in short a domestic refrigerator, which is being used time to time everywhere in our domestic purpose itself. Thank you. Let us start the operation of our air conditioning system in our laboratories. What we are showing here, the air conditioning test rig. In front of us, at the top, we are having our digital wattmeter used for measuring the energy used during the test period. at the left, next the thermometer itself, which also again records six different thermometer temperatures at six different points. Below it, the low pressure and high pressure pressure gauges, which is recording the pressure at the low pressure and high pressure side of the system. High pressure side is the red one, and low pressure is the green one itself. Under that, we are having our main switch, which starts and stops the system. And over that, we have having another switch, which is written as on and off, which is used to run and off the switch of the heating coil itself. In the right of it, we are having our expansion or throttling device, capillary device tube, throttling device or capillary tube, which is used as an expansion of the system itself. Inside the carriage cover, we are having a condenser itself, which is viewable at the front as well as rear side of the test rig itself. Inside the fixture, we are having our compressor and the air cooling fan, which is used to drain the air of the cooling system. This is the outlet of the air conditioner. Inside, the white coils, while cooling coils are visible in front of us, and before that, just in front of all of everything, we are having a red shaped coil, which is as the heating coil, which is used for heating the cold fan if necessary. This is the overall function of refrigerator, and this is the intake and intake point of the air, and below that the temperature set for the refrigerator, for the air conditioner, is available here.
Okay, so far I have showed the still photos as well as videos of our laboratory equipments, which I have shown you the compressor. This is the compressor, condenser, expansion valve, and evaporator. We have shown the hermetically sealed compressor everywhere for all four sixes, and same throttle valve or expansion valve in all four test rigs, but evaporator or condenser are different from rigs to rigs. Fin tube types condenser are being shown for two of them, and one is for air cooled condenser, which is shown in the for the tank type evaporator test rig. Evaporator is also different. One evaporator is like a tank, which is holding a cold water. Another evaporator is just like a open system, which is kept used for cooling certain items kept inside it. Thirdly, the evaporator is our familiar refrigerator, which was inside is shown, where in our so-called high heat area, freezing point, whose side is being surrounded by our evaporating coils, and the coils absorb the cold air latent heat of evaporation of the refrigerant from the atmosphere of inside the refrigerator itself, and it is being circulated by this weight of the heavy air, which is supposed to come down, and comparatively hotter air is supposed to go out, and by this way that again becomes cold due to the refrigerant cooling effect of the evaporator, and thus whole again heat that goes down, thus the circulation is automatically takes place without use of any fans in case of a small capacity refrigerator itself. Now what happens, you see the hermetically compressor which it uses is one third tonnage, means around 300 kg of tonnages, kgs of capacity is required to work on 220 to 30, 50 years operating lines, as well, which is our domestic energy lines. And we are using a refrigerant named as R134 for refrigerators and refrigerant 401. What is going on is here. Paper. Now, what we have this energy meter or for compression filter dryer here, somewhere here. It is not always present. Next is special gauges suction and discharge gauges on suction line and discharge line, imported specifically for R134 refrigerant itself. The suction line, the temperature is low, discharge line temperature is high. So the high temperature line, which is deep discharge line, which is given as a red type pressure gauge, as well as the lines are decorated in red so that we know from And switches for start digital temperature indicator for various points in degree centigrade with 0.100 degree centigrade probes. Switches for other parts and gas charging valve. So now what happens? What is the a vapor compression refrigeration system is an improved type of air refrigeration system where a suitable working substance instead of air is used as refrigerant. It condenses in the condenser, it evaporates in the evaporator, compresses in the compressor, and expands in the throttling valve itself. And the refrigerator never does leave the system, and the same refrigerator being circulated again and again throughout the system. So here we can say the compressor acts like a heart of a human body, and these refrigerants acts as a blood of like human body, which is sucked and compressed by the heart to different area to different area of the body. And same process is being used in this refrigerating system itself. Now, what is compressor? At low temperature and pressure, refrigerant enters in a vapor state and drawn or sucked from the evaporator to the compressor through an inlet suction delivery valve. When it is compressed, reciprocating compressor system to high temperature and pressure. This refrigerant then high temperature and pressure then goes into condenser to a discharge valve B. The condenser or cooler consists of coils of pipe, which through which refrigerant with high temperature and pressure passes through and is condenses and releases the heat to the surroundings to convert it from gaseous to liquid inside in the form. And during this change of state, this releases heat into the atmosphere of the surroundings. Next, it comes the receiver. Generally, all these condenser throttle valves, which used as an expander or expansion devices, we are supposed to get the condenser refrigerant as a liquid in a liquid form. So refrigerant after the expansion condenser starts reciprocating, starts accumulating a liquid system in a liquid vase or receiver. from which, from the bottom of the receiver, it is being transmitted to the expander or throttle valve only in the liquid form, and the gaseous form remains in the top, and it can slowly condenses to liquid itself. Now, it goes then the expansion valve. The expansion function of the expansion and throttle valve is to convert liquid refrigerant at high pressure and low temperature, or to low temperature, low pressure and low temperature. So, what the expansion and throttle valve receives? The liquid at high temperature and pressure, liquid refrigerant at high temperature and pressure, which it converts into low temperature and low pressure liquid and sent to the evaporator itself. Now, what happens to evaporator? A evaporator consists of coils or pipes in which liquid refrigerant at low temperature. Liquid refrigerant at low temperature is evaporated to the gaseous refrigerant at low temperature and with temperature, and thus absorbing the latent heat of vaporization from the surrounding media, which is to be cooled. So what is going on? All the refrigerants are passing through the pipe surrounding the space of the evaporator itself, and refrigerants are in a liquid state at low temperature and low pressure, and this evaporated to gaseous state as the temperature inside the evaporator initially was more than that of the refrigerant itself, which allows to evaporate the refrigerant, and thus which the latent heat of evaporation is being absorbed from the inside atmosphere of the refrigerator, and it is being cooled, and refrigerant thus converted from liquid to gas at low temperature, but in low temperature